This is Apurva Pawar, student of MBA Aviation, and today I'm going to present the requirements, question answer, and benefits of cabin crew for all airlines. So let's begin. Let's take an overview. Who is the cabin crew? What are the requirements for becoming the cabin crew? Question and answer session for cabin crew, interview, and benefits of becoming cabin crew. Who is the cabin crew? Cabin crew is a flight attendant and is a crew member responsible for the safety of the passenger. Historically, during the early era of commercial aviation, the position was staffed by the young cabin boys who was assisted as a passenger, two passengers, and cabin boys. After that, cabin boys were replaced by the female nurses, originally called the stewardess. What are the requirements for becoming cabin crews for domestic airlines? The nationality of national air cab for carriers. Passport. Their age limit should be between 18 to 27 years, and some airline allowed you to become cabin crew in the 32 age limit. And your educational qualification should be, 10 plus 2, that is HSC, from any recognized board or university. You should have a good communication skill in Hindi and English for domestic airlines. You should possess the pleasant personality with immaculate color and good body language. Your height should be minimum of 155 centimeter and with appropriate weight as per mentioned in BMI. Acceptable eyesight, that is 6x6, and acceptable limit is plus minus 1.5. Airlines should give priority to every other airline in India. Basically, they should give priority to unmarried candidates. So, to become the cabin crew member, they should have the basic knowledge of body language, and they must be well groomed. No tattoos should be visible when you are in the uniform. What are the requirements for becoming cabin crew for international airlines? So at least your age limit should be 21 years at the time of joining. The height requirement is minimum arm reach of 212 centimeters on tiptoes for female. Minimum height of 160 centimeter for both male and female. High school grade is 12, that is HSC from any recognized university. You should have fluent in English non-language. And no visible tattoos again while you are in airline. You should be adaptable for new situation and new places. Physically, you should maintain your physical fitness for this demanding role with a healthy body mass index. You must possess the ability to work with a multinational team, because you are working with the international airline. So you will surround yourself with various different candidates who are coming from various different countries. You should possess the outgoing personality with excellent interpersonal skill. Applicants should be travel freak, because you have to travel the world, you have to serve the people. So they should, travel freak. You should be passionate about the customer service, willingness to relocate anywhere in the world. So what are the cabin crews are trained for? So they are trained for safety and emergency procedures which may arise in any duration of flight. Safety equipment, they know the basic safety equipment to handle the any emergency situation. Firefighting training, they are also trained for first aid. Galley management means which kind of cuisine you have to serve for the various classes, for food preparation and services, passenger cares and customer relation. Of course, you have to maintain the customer relation because you are the frontliner staff. You should be well groomed. You should have basic aircraft knowledge at least by the time you eventually get the familiar with the aircraft, but the basic knowledge you should possess. Then customs and immigration regulation, you must have the basic knowledge of. So what kind of possible question can be asked during the interview? So first let's see, what do you think you have the best qualities. So you should know your best qualities: strong grasp on relationship, while also being able to listen to others, competitive mindset, friendly, I can create friendly environment around me, outgoing personality, to assist the people. I like to assist the people. And you should have the critical thinking, attention to details. You should have excellent communication skill with every other passenger. What skills should a member of an airline cabin crew expected to have? They must have, of course, 90% of your communication skill will matter there. The communicating, listening, understanding, not only the communicating, but also the listening and understanding to others. Approachable and welcoming manner. Then ability to multitask, knowledgeable and able to think on the spot. Calm attitude and calming presence. You shouldn't be so much hyper if some adverse environment is created there in flight. So you should be calm always. You should be able to listen to others. How would you deal with an unruly passenger? Give us an example of when you have dealt with an unruly customer. If you are fresher, then probably you don't have any experience. But if you are experienced person, then you should be able to deliver. I will not be judgmental towards the other customer. I will carefully consider the situation, figure out what kind of problem, or give the positive answers, so that ultimately you can create the customer relationship. Or also you can say that you wanted to help them as much you could. You will try to see things from the customer's perspective, like that. So next is, do you work better as a part of team or on your own? This kind of question are very tricky question, because ultimately you have to work on your own also during your job and also as a team. So this kind of questions are very diplomatic questions. So you have to listen that carefully and answer accordingly. For example, someone or something inspired to do means if your senior person is inspiring you, then definitely you can work as part of a team, or you can use your presence of mind on that time. So next is, how would you deal with the colleague you didn't get on with? Recall a time when you had to work with colleagues that you didn't get on with. So simple solution to this question is to focus on being the professional, of course, because you should say that we are human, so basically mistakes can happen by everyone. So you should be put your professionalism into that. You could confine to small space with your colleagues for long periods of time in your job perspective. So you have to adjust yourself. You have to maintain your relations, your balance between both of you. So ultimately, that will affect. If any negative thing is happening, that ultimately affect the passenger. So you have to deal with this kind of question also. What are your hobbies? Recently, I have attended one session. On that session, that ma'am said that. This kind of question, this seems very basic question, but from your hobbies, they can define your attitude. So be careful with this kind of question. They seem very basic, but they become crucial part of your interview session. So you can give the answer according to your job. Like suppose you are applying for cabin crew, then you must say that team sports, participating in team sports shows the desire to work alongside with others. Or I love art or designs. I think art about related hobbies. You should think about your related hobbies to key traits required for cabin crew members. So these kind of comparison can happen out there. So next is, how do you handle stress? So the mention anything that makes you positive, like you play something, you play music, you dance to release your stress, or you read positive things or books to handle your stress. So mention this kind of answers. So what would you do if you are not successful in this time? Then your answer should be positive, that I will analyze my mistakes if I fail during the interview, and I'll try to rectify, I'll improve myself, I will not give up, I will apply until I will become successful. So this kind of positive attitude makes you different from any other candidate. Why we should hire you? This is a very basic question. In every other sector, this kind of question is asked. So mention about whatever past experience that you have that are related to cabin crew. If you are not fresher, with your experience, you can definitely contribute and provide the highest level of service to the passenger, leaving with a good impression on them. So do you like children? So definitely on board, you will face many children, during the flight. Then it is not, you should say that it is not a burden. I will play with them. I will go along with them. I will make them comfortable. Say whatever you are comfortable with the deal with kids. So, this kind of positive attitude you should for this. So tell us about your current or your previous job, if you are not pressure. Then the goal is here to convince them that your experience is useful and complement the role of a cabin crew. You have learned something from your past experiences, that definitely that experience you can use with your their airlines. So that you can have some positive impact on them. So, create some story or tell some story to impress them in a positive manner. So, what kind of languages you can speak? So, mention all the languages you can speak, even the basic one. Tell us the aircraft that we fly. That shows how much you are researching about the airlines you are applying. So what kind of aircraft you are flying, what type of aircraft that airline is flying. So just don't be ignorant about that. So face that, have a basic understanding of about the airline, and answer this kind of question. So for example, that airline is flying only Airbus, then mention the Airbus industry, mention about that aircraft, mention about the types of aircraft. So why did you choose our airline and not others? So being a cabin crew is your ambition, and do not mind working in airline so long you achieve it. Means you have to balance this question properly, in a proper manner. You can say, this is my dream company to work with. So this kind of question you can answer, you can say. So if there is no more vegetarian meal, what you, would you do for a passenger that insist on a veg meal? So this kind of question, judges your presence of mind. So, say like, I won't say no to passenger immediately. Just say that you will try to check if there is any crew meal or veg meal left in premium section, and more than willing to offer them. So you can say like that. Why would you think good grooming is important for a cabin? Because being cabin crew is not just about the serving passenger. You will become the frontline staff by being a presentable. You give a good image on and impression on both yourself and to the airline that employs you. No one would love someone who is missing to attend them. Besides, by looking good, you will be more confident about yourself. This is the basic human quality. So of course you have to say according to that. So how do you adapt the changes? You can say the flexible, I'm flexible person, I can adapt the changes easily. I have that ability to adapt any kind of changes. You can say like that. So what would you do if someone disagrees with you? So of course, in a positive manner, how you will approach that matter, approach this question, that matters. So you can say that you will try to understand what problem is and find a win-win situation for both parties. And there is a saying that it is better to find a friend than create an enemy. It makes life easier, and I'm sure you will agree with this. Me, you can say like that. What types of passengers do you like to serve? So as a flight attendant, you should not be discriminated with passengers. You should treat each and every passengers equally. Don't be prioritize yourself with your work. Being in cabin crew, you need to be all rounder because you are ready to meet all types of people. You should be ready to meet all types of people. What do you see yourself in 5 years from now? This question is very important because that shows your positive approach towards yourself. So say this, you can see yourself as a senior cabin crew, say the positive with positive attitude, and ready to move and share your knowledge with new cabin crews. I will support my junior colleagues and all. You will continue to learn, improving, because life is a continuous learning journey. So what do you your parents, loved ones, and or loved ones think about you becoming a cabin crew? So you can say they are very helpful to you and will be happy and proud to achieve your dreams as a cabin crew. And whatever it is, I hope that I could help you be a better candidate. So say things, positive things, answer positively. So what kind of benefits cabin crew gets? They travel the world. They are paid to travel. So after becoming cabin crew, you can travel anywhere according to your schedule, and you don't have to pay any utilities or rent. Ultimately, airlines will pay for you. Of course, you will get a good salary prospects. Easier promotions. You have access of 5-star hotels and restaurants. You will get cheaper flight tickets to your family and yourself also. You'll make friends from all cultures. So thank you so much. For my favorite quote, one of my favorite quotes said by American Airlines is, for most people, the sky is the limit. For flight attendants, the sky is. Thank you.